Hi everyone, welcome to Career Views, I'm Nancy. In this video today, I'm going to answer all your questions regarding notice period. I have been getting a lot of comments on my videos regarding the queries about notice period. What are the employee rights? I'm getting a lot of questions from a lot of employees regarding their rights during the notice period. What they should do, how much should be the notice period, what should be the notice period if they are on probation. What they must do when they are on a probation period and they decide to resign. What is the right way to submit your papers and talk about the resignation? In case they plan to buy out the notice period, what are the legal clauses? How to negotiate your notice period, or moreover, if you decide to buy out a notice, what you must do. So without any further ado, let's start the video and let me answer all your questions. Today in this video, I'm going to talk about notice period. It is the most sought after topic. So in this video today, I'll be answering all your questions related to notice period. So stay tuned with me. So let's begin with what should be the right amount of notice to give to your employer. The right amount of notice is always mentioned in your employment contract. So when you decide to put your resignation, the first thing that you must do, even before putting your papers, is to refer to your employment contract. Look at it, how much is the notice period if you decided to resign during your probation or being a permanent employee. If there is nothing mentioned in your contract, which is least likely the case in many of the contracts, you must serve 2 weeks of notice to maintain your credibility as a good employee or to give a proper handover to any tasks that were assigned to you. 2 weeks is an ideal time to give your employer to find your replacement. But in general, the notice period could be from 1 month to 3 months. For some precious positions, it could even go up to 6 months. I'm talking about in the medical field. But totally depending on your industry, the notice period varies. So be professional when it comes to your notice period. If you have given an interview and you have been successful, never quote the wrong notice period. Never promise or give false hopes to your future employer. You would put yourself in a problem because later on they would doubt your professionalism if you change your words based on your extended notice period. If you have done that and the opportunity is really great and you want to pursue the new job, then be prepared to buy out your notice period. When you are in an interview stage with the new employer and you see things going positive, the first thing that you must do is look at your contract. Look thoroughly at your contract. What are the other clauses beyond your notice period? You must review the other clauses beyond your notice period. There might be clients that you cannot work with. There might be a non-compete clause. There might be a clause of a labor ban. So you must be very careful while making a career transition. If you got the offer and you've decided to make a move, you should approach your exit negotiation very properly. Generally, an employee has two options. One, to serve the notice which is mentioned in the employment contract. And the second option is to buy out your notice period. If you've got a job that offers a promising salary, you are so keen to take up that assignment as early as possible to begin your new monthly take-home salary as an increased one, there's no harm in buying out the notice period. Now, when we talk about buying out the notice period, it could be from either of the parties, the new employer or the employee. Some of the employers are open to pay the salary to the existing employer and buy out the employee's notice period. In this case, employee is in a win-win situation. He gets to join a company which is better than the previous one, and the notice period also is sorted by the new employer. But unfortunately, very few of the organization offer such arrangement. If you have to buy out your notice period yourself, you must need to see how much notice period you can buy out and what are the terms and conditions mentioned in the contract. Give you an example of how buying out your notice period works. Buying out the notice means giving away your salary in lieu of the time that you spent with the organization. For example, you have a 30 days notice period upon resignation and you decide to join immediately somewhere. In that case, you could pay the salary which is due for 30 days to your current employer. In that case, you need not to work with the employer, but you get a relieving letter early. This amount is also mentioned as a recovery amount in the full and final settlement that an employee receives. If you have a great employer that is ready to buy back your notice for you, this recovery amount is settled by the new organization at the time of joining. But in case you are paying the notice period amount from your pocket, then also it's called the recovery amount, but you don't get it settled from the new employer. That goes entirely from your pocket. There are certain circumstances in which employee choose to buy out the notice. The new job pays you way higher than your current salary. The organization is really great and you want to join them immediately. Your interview and selection happen based on your immediate availability. These are some of the situations where employee needs a buyout of the notice period. In normal circumstances, employees are not allowed to take any privileged leaves during the notice period. For any worse situation, if you've decided to take leaves during your notice period, that is also considered as buying out the notice. Either you have to cover up those days by working out extra for the company, or you could pay them in cash to the employer so that your relieving letter doesn't get stuck with the current employer and you leave the company on the said timeline. Now let's talk about an early exit negotiation. Of course, an employee wants to leave early without paying an amount to the current employer from their own pocket. So the best way to do so is leaving in good terms. Make sure you resign in person. Talk to your boss and tell them that what kind of organization you are joining and what are your reasons. Before approaching your HR or your line manager for an exit negotiation, make sure you do your homework, which includes looking at your contract's terms and conditions. Secondly, reviewing how much outstanding leave balance you have. Sometimes the employees could settle their leaves through the notice period. Generally, you get the settlement based on your leaves, how much leave you can carry forward to the next year. This includes as a part of end of settlement. So do check out how many holidays you have pending. If you could use those holidays as a part of your notice period and reduce your notice period. Another option that could be used is working part-time for your current employer. But in that case, your relieving letter might get stuck. You would not get relieving letter on your last working day and joining the new employer. If your current and future employer agrees to have you on board at the same time, whereas you're working part-time for one organization and as a full-time employee for another, this is a win-win situation. If you could spare enough time to work part-time and settle your notice period. The third way that you could negotiate your notice period is a task-based negotiation. What are your assignments? What kind of projects you're working on? You could always try and expedite the process to complete those projects ahead of time. If you could ensure that, then definitely you could ask them that my project will be over by this date. I'm ready to provide proper handover, proper documentation, take everything in written, and then proceed with the task-based negotiation of your exit. It could be that the employer has too much to take on. With a leaving employee, serving notice, not ready to serve notice, want to leave early, employer might get bogged down with so much coming on their plate. So don't get disheartened if you are not able to secure an early negotiation for exit. But be on the task, be professional, try to complete your projects, keep your boss posted, and retry for an early exit after 15 days. But in this case, it's not an assured situation. You cannot commit to the new employer a certain date. Whereas buying out or settling with your leave amount ensures an early exit with a proper timeline. But it's worth trying with the HR or your line manager if you have a little bit flexibility from both the parties. A big mistake that most of the candidates do is over-promising. This is not a good idea. Some people see a good job, apply for that, get interviewed, and mention that we are available immediately. Without looking at the contract, without considering what would happen if they are not able to serve the notice, they would resign at one place, they've lost that job. The new place, if they are not able to join at the right or said time, they would lose the offer letter or the credibility. So don't put yourself in a difficult situation by being dishonest. During your interview, the best way is being very honest about your notice period. Keep a little bit time for yourself, a week maybe, to rejuvenate, recharge before joining the new job, and manage your timelines accordingly. But never lie during an interview that you are available to join by this date without doing the groundwork. As we move ahead to the last phase of your notice period, let's talk about your legal rights. Employees get in difficult situations sometimes. They are threatened by the employers that we would not give you the required documentation, we would not give you the pay slips, and employees are concerned that what do we do next? Do we withdraw our resignation? See, as an employee decides to negotiate at certain levels, whether it's a salary negotiation, it's a notice period negotiation, employers are way smarter. They also have certain ways to negotiate with you. By hook or by crook, they don't want an employee to leave. So they put certain clauses in your contract, especially for the precious positions. But at the same time, when an employee resigns, they see a lot of work coming their way of finding a replacement, doing interviews, engaging, teaching, training new staff. Rather, they would keep an employee, but they cannot tell you to stay. Some employers do negotiate through offering a higher salary. But others, what they do is they tell you, okay, buyout. Some employees are not ready to use the buyout option. They mind paying their salary. So this gives employer a chance to make the employee stay. But understand, what are your legal rights? First thing, they cannot withhold your documents if you are serving the notice period properly. If you decide to buy out a notice period, they cannot do anything because you are compensating your notice period with the payment of your time. Third thing, look at your leave balance. If you have a leave balance, you have the complete right to use your leave balance in your notice period. Many of the employers don't want to share the payslips for the records of the new employer. In that case, you could use your bank statements. Make all the other transactions blurred, but use your salary credit as your payslips. In that case, you could show. When it comes to relieving letter, relieving letter is your right, but after a formal exit interview and a proper handover. If you have done that, your employer has no right to hold the relieving letter. Understand where the problem is coming from. Is it at a human level, legal level, or at your level? Be your worst critic. See how you are leaving. If you are leaving in good terms, you are doing everything professionally, then your employer is on the wrong side. You have the complete right to file a complaint against the employer in the labor court. But keep it as the last option, because I never suggest leaving in bad terms to any of the employees. So see what are your options available, at what stage you could go to the labor court. What are your questions about the notice period? Maybe you have some things that you should discuss with your future employer or your future HR. HR know all the legalities and the labor laws. Take them in good faith. Ask them. Point to note here. What employers do is, relieving letter releases you from all the responsibilities. So it gives power to the employer. Employers sometimes hold the relieving letter to make an employee stay, but it doesn't mean that you cannot join the new job without a relieving letter. This is their last weapon to use on you. Talk to your future employer or the future HR. Tell them clearly that relieving letter is pending, but I have given my handover. Always take a copy of original handover for yourself. Make sure you do not leave any documentation pending, any handover documentation, any dues clearance, anything balance which is outstanding from your side should not be there. Make sure you tick all the boxes and then just wait for the relieving letter. If your employer is not ready to give you a relieving letter even after that, then you are free to go to the labor court. But while waiting for a relieving letter, you can definitely join a new job. So I get a lot of questions regarding, I don't have the relieving letter yet. I have done my notice. Can I join the new job? My employer is not giving me the relieving letter. Yes, you can join the new job even without a relieving letter. Keep reminding your previous employer through emails. And mark your email reminders as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This will serve as a proof. Use official email addresses for the people you are writing to about relieving letter. Keep all your proofs of follow-up and everything else with you, so that if required, you can use them as a valid proof of your follow-ups and your employer not releasing your documents. If you are right, there is no need to be scared. Law is there to protect you. Another situation where you should reach out to the labor court is if an employer denies your buyout. Some employers deny, no, we don't have this clause, you cannot buy out your notice period, you cannot settle it with money, you have to be physically present. This is all just to make your life difficult. But as per the labor law, there is no such clause that you cannot buy out your notice period. Try gently, get a little firm, but if nothing works out, then last resort is to file a complaint against your employer for not allowing you to buy out your notice period. Another suggestion that I give employees is to cover themselves up. Keep all the receipts, documents, relieving letter and experience letter. Another weapon used by most of the employers is, we will spoil your career by not giving a positive reference check. It is a normal situation for most of the employers to hold employees with them. A good way to cover yourself up is taking an experience letter, having LinkedIn recommendations, from the same employer. Keep a record of your recommendations. Keep gathering all the positive client feedback about you. They would suffice in case of a reference check. When it comes to reference check, keep up with at least one or two employees in an organization who would say good about you. This is the sole reason I tell employees not to leave in bad terms. But it's not such a big deal that would spoil your career. If an employer has decided deliberately to trouble you while leaving, they could say things like this. But there is no need to panic. If you have an experience letter, you can give it to your future employer or tell the HR that I have left because of notice issues. There might not be a positive feedback. What are the other documents that I could produce to show my professionalism and credibility? Why to use only one organization as your reference point? There might be other people or external clients who have worked with you. Ask them to provide a positive feedback or a positive reference check. Rather than sticking to an employer who you have not left in good terms. Notice period is a crucial period of anybody's career. It's very natural to feel overwhelmed. But if we use logic during our notice period, it gets a bit easier to pass this transition. I really hope you found this video useful for your notice period. Check the description. I'll be leaving a link of a lot of other videos that I have made for exit process, what to mention during an exit interview, do's and don'ts of an exit interview, what should be prepared for exit interview questions. All the questions that you need to answer during the transition from one job to another. I'm very sure these videos would help you in deciding upon your transition. I would also leave a link about the video regarding resignation, how to resign gracefully. It also contains templates for resignation. Do check these videos out and let me know in the comments if you have any question regarding your notice period, resignation, exit process. I'll be very happy to answer your questions. Do subscribe to my channel. Keep watching Career Views for more career videos. I cover a wide variety of topics to help people like you for having a smooth job search operation, interview process, career transition, and a lot of other things. Let me know how are you liking my videos. What are the other topics that you want me to cover? I would make videos on those topics. Do visit my website www.careerviews.com to read more about my career blog, and you can also download some things in the free resources library like ATS resume, LinkedIn banners, and much more. Stay tuned to Career Views. Thank you for watching.